Let me read to you Psalm 33 and verses 12 onwards. It says here, "Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, and the people whom he hath chosen for his own inheritance." Verse 18, "Behold, the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy." Fascinating balance here in Scripture. In verse 12, we see that God is the one who chose his nation, the people, for his own inheritance. And yet in verse 18, we see that the eye of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy. There are two paradoxes in the Christian life that we need to grasp. And this is it, that God is the God of election, and yet it is those who fear and trust in him that will be saved. You see, how can these two things be balanced out? I do not know. Scripture doesn't seek to balance these two realities, but both are equally true. Again, there are people today who swing to one extreme of thinking about election as if man has no part to play, or people think that it is all about man's choice and God is helpless in the people that will be saved. Both are dangerous conclusions. Looking at the scripture countless times, there is that balance that scripture portrays, that God fully selects and elects, and man is fully responsible for fearing and hoping in him. In verses 16 and 17 of Psalm 33, the Bible says, "There is no king saved by the multitude of an host. A mighty man is not delivered by much strength. An horse is a vain thing for safety, neither shall he deliver any by his great strength." Let's tell us that today, this is what we need to be humble before God about. That we are not saved because we are great, we are not saved because we are capable or resourceful. As what John himself would say, we are born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. God have mercy on us. Today, your responsibility is to humble yourself, turn from your sin, and believe in Jesus. And you know what? The Bible says you will be saved. And if you already have trusted in Jesus, boast not that you chose Jesus, but that God in his sovereign grace has chosen you. May this balance be helpful to you as you read Psalm 33. God bless.